love you, Jesus. Lord, we just love you, God. We just love you, God. Jesus, just tell me, love you. You are so beautiful.
Part of me, Lord. You're beautiful.
your presence, God. Swear I love you, God. Just right here, God, I just want to just sit in your presence, God, and be filled by your glory. Just tell him, God, I don't care about anything else but me and you right now. God, the more I seek after the one I love, the more I'll find you.
The more I find
you. Lord, your word says that if I knock, the door will be open for me. Jesus, here I am knocking, Lord. The more I find you. Here I am, God. The more I love you. Jesus. I want to just sit right here, God. Explain it, God. It's more than I can even stand in your presence. your love just surround them. Let your love just go in and soak them, God. Oh, God. Oh, God, take us into that secret place, God, where it's just you and us, Lord. Nothing else matters. The world doesn't matter. People around us don't matter, God, but your presence. God, let us just be there right now. In this moment, God, I just want to sit at your feet, God. Drink from the cup. For me, God, the way your heart beats for those you love. Oh, God, you love the ones, Lord. You love the sinner, God. Lord, you love them all, God. Lord, you love the drug addicts, God. You love the prostitutes, God. You love the homosexuals, God. How much you love them, God. Spend time with you, God. Lord, the children that are lost, God, how much you love them. The backslider, God, how much you love them, God. I just pray right now, God, that your presence, God, meets them right where they're at. Lord, as they just come in your presence, God, let people be changed and transformed, God. Let their lives be healed and set free and delivered for your glory, God. Let it be all about who you are, God. God, let it be about you, Jesus. Jesus, the one that loves us, Jesus. The truth, Lord. The truth, let us see the truth, God. Let us see your love. Let us see your compassion, God. Lord. God, turn us back to you, Jesus.
This love is so deep, it's more than I can stand. I'm melting in your
God, turn us back to you, God. Turn us back to you, God. Turn us back to your presence, God. Turn us back to your presence, God. Turn us back to the ones you love, Lord God. We are them, God, the ones you love, the ones you set apart, God. Turn us back, Lord, towards you, Father. Let your love come forth, Lord, and let it just soak us, Lord. Let it just fill us right now, God. Let it just come in, God, and multiply and pour into, Lord. Oh, Lord, even unclean vessels, Lord, can be cleaned by your presence. Even unclean vessels can be sanctified by your glory, God. So I ask you this morning, Lord, that you set a fire in our hearts, Lord, that we might love you more, that we might serve you more, God, that we might praise you more, God. Turn our hearts towards you, God. Turn our hearts towards the one we love, Jesus. God, we just want more. God, I just want more. Just tell God, set a fire in my heart, Lord. A fire that never burns out. A fire that blazes so strong, God. And all I want to do is seek you. All I want to do is spend time with you. All I want to do is love on you, God. Set a fire, God. Let me be forever changed, Lord God, today, Lord. Let me be forever changed and transformed and renewed, God. Today, just lift your hands and say, God, today is the day, God, that I turn my heart back to you, God. Today's the day, God, that I seek you like never before. Today's the day, God, that I want you to set a fire in my heart that never burns out. Today's the day, God, I want change. I want more of you and less of me, God. Lord, give me a love for your people, God. Give me a love for the lost. Give me a love for those, God, that need you, God. Replenish my heart, God, with your truth, Lord. Because I want more of you, God. Lord, just fill me, God. Just fill me, God, to overflowing this morning, God. Lord, empty me of everything else, Lord. And just fill me with you, God. Your love, your peace, your joy, your strength, God. No more compromise, God. want more of you, God, and less of me, God. Lord, now is not the time for me to slow down, God. Now is not the time for me to put my sword down. Now is the time for me to do what you say, God. So here I am, God, just a vessel, Lord, wanting to be filled with your presence, God. Wanting to be, Father God, the ones you have called the set out ones, Lord, for your purpose, God. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Thank you right now, Father God, that you're doing a mighty work in your people, Father God, that you're changing some things, some mindset, some old things, some attitudes, Father God, that you're changing right now, Father God. And I thank you that your power go forth, Father God, and declare right now that you, Father God, will be faithful, Father God, to finish what you started in your children this morning, Father God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, Father God. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. How many want change this morning? But if you want change, please don't just come to the front. I want to pray with you this morning. Amen. You know what? Change, it's nothing that you can do, but it's simply obeying and allowing God to do what he needs to do you in you. Amen. That's it. It's a complete surrender of self and obedience unto God. And you know what? And in this process of when we change some things, people are getting things off. You know what? We have to hear the voice of God this morning. Amen. Because the only way he can construct and build something up is to tear some things down, amen, that don't belong there. But we have to be willing to release those things. We have to be willing to let those things go, amen. And this change coming forward, you know what? It's by simply listening and doing what he wants us to do. That means when he says this and he says that, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. But remember, he's doing something. He's bringing forth change, not us. Because all we're doing is being obedient to his voice, amen. And when we do that, change is coming forth. Things are going to change. How many of us are tired of living the way we're living? How many are tired, honestly?
Yeah. Yeah.
How many are tired of struggling with the things that we struggle with day in and day out? Right? Think about it. We're captive by those things. Amen? Those things that we deal with every day that we can't get rid of. You know what? We're trying to do them ourselves, God said. But you know what? At this moment, if you leave it up to me, and you, honestly, if you completely surrender everything unto me, and you be obedient to my voice and do what I say, those things begin to drop off. Amen? Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Just lift your hands up and just begin to praise God right now. We're going to pray with you in a minute, okay? I don't want to move on until God does what he needs to do. Amen? Father God, I thank you this morning for everyone up here, Father God. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. I thank you right now that change is coming forth, Father God. I thank you that old ways are dropping off, Father God, and that you're going to renew their mind and their spirit, Father God, right now, Father God, as they surrender everything unto you this morning, Father God, that you're going to begin to build them up in your word, Father God. You're going to begin to build them up by your spirit, Father God, that they will hear your voice clearer than ever before, Father God, that they will heed your voice, Father God. I thank you for transformation taking place right now. I thank you for a transition taking place, Father God. From one place, the old mindset, to a new place, to godly thinking, to God's way of thinking, to God's attitude. Amen. We thank you right now, Father God. We thank you for your power coming forward, Father God, in Jesus' name.
Love, 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 love Daddy, Yeah. stop fighting, because I'm going to reveal it to you. And you're going to go to your mom, and mom's going to say, I already knew, Caitlin. I've been telling you, Caitlin. You hear me? You said you lost your future, but you got to be ready to stop fighting.
There's no love like you.
I just speak the truth of God over you. Everything else, release her in the name of Jesus with no authority.
Set a fire down in my soul that I
of God, and it can come, and it can be manifested in the life. God says, where you think that you're not making anything, you're not doing anything, you're not causing waves and ripples, God says, it's not above water that you're working, that God's working. It's beneath the water that God's working. He says, when you throw the pebble, you don't see anything. He says, you're saying, God, why isn't this taking, why isn't it going quicker? Why? Because you know what? That seed that you're throwing in the water is trickling down to the bottom to get to the very deep, dark places that nobody else sees, that nobody else knows about. That's why when you think, oh, that's not happening to my family, God is saying, no, it is. You just can't see the seed yet, but the seed is in the ground, and God's going to start watering it. Trust me, God says, because I am in control. But every seed you have planted and everyone around you is going to start giving fruit, because it's time now to receive breakthrough. Yeah. It's time now for things to change. It's time now for growth to come. So I'm letting you know, woman of God, that God said that He is bringing increase on those seeds. The more you put in the Word of God, the more you speak the Word of God, the truth of God, the revelation's going to start coming. You might not see it right away, but it's the pebble that fell in the water. It went in really, really deep. And when you go in, you know, even the scientists can't even get to every crevice of the deepness of the water. But my Word can, even past the darkest places. If they don't think there's light, have they not found the fish with light in dark areas, sister? Woo! And why would they not find my light in darkness? Everything's planned and purpose and position. He said, continue to give the Word. You might be thinking, I'm too harsh. No, the Word is the truth, and that's what you give. Every seed you plant is a fruit to the tree that you're going to possess. So He says, continue to drop your fruit, because others are listening and others are watching. Jesus. So please, of God. Release it from our own self. Woo! Just release it from our own thought patterns. See, God said, you thought it was you, Carol, but it ain't. He said, oh, you can't say, oh, God, is it going to be easy? Woo! Wait. Woo! I'm working the good work. You just keep saying thank you. Stay
needs.
Thank you, Lord,
that I may have more than enough.
That I may have more than enough.
To give to the work of Jesus Christ. Amen. We thank you, Father God, and we honor you, Father. You bless your people, Father God, that you met every need, Father God, in Jesus' name. We speak increase, increase, increase in the house of God, in the people of God. Amen. And I believe children's church, go to the back. Amen. Bring the tithe offering to the front. Bring, take kids to the back or drive them off.
Everybody rain and fire. need for suffering to go in your house.
Satisfied with goodness, or indeed he has no burial, I say that a stillborn child is better than he. In Ecclesiastes 5:10, that he who loves silver will not be satisfied with silver, nor he with the who loves abundance will with increase. This also is vanity. Isaiah 55:2-3 says, why do you spend for what is not bread? Spend money for what is not bread, and wages for what does not satisfy. Listen carefully to me, and eat what is good, and let your soul delight itself in abundance. Incline your ear and come to me. Hear, and your soul shall live, and I will make an everlasting covenant with you, the sure mercies of David. Amen. And this morning I want to talk about spiritual fullness. You know, what God wants us to understand is that we will never truly be satisfied by trying to please our flesh. The more you give it, and I'm going to say amen to this, the more you give the flesh, the more it wants.
Yeah.
Is that right? Yeah. You know what, we can go out and we can get raises and raises and raises to satisfy us. But you know what? You'll never be satisfied because you can go get a $2 raise, $3 raise, but eventually you're going to want more and more and more. Why? Yeah. Because you're trying to satisfy the flesh. Now listen to this here. We try to so hard and fail to satisfy the flesh. That's why we get frustrated and we give up. Amen? Now think about this for a minute. I read it down when I was back in the office a while ago. Think about it for a minute. It says, we are trying to satisfy the very thing God told us to crucify daily.
Yeah.
Your flesh will never have enough. Your flesh will never be satisfied or content. Why? Because the flesh has to do with the worldly things, the things Adam awakened by disobedience. Does that make sense? But the spirit that we should be trying to fill up and be satisfied, the spirit has to do with the things of God that was brought about by Jesus for redemption. So we work and we work and we do and we do and we do, but we still feel frustrated. Why is that? Because it's not, our flesh is not looking for the spiritual things. It's our spirit, man. See, we give place to the flesh and we feed the flesh. We build up the flesh, but our spirit is dying every single day because we don't give it what it needs. And what it needs is what? It's the things of God. It needs the joy, the peace, and the love of God. Money came by that. Your job came by that. Amen. So we're struggling to try to fight and feed and feed and feed. And then, oh, you know what? Just forget it. I give up. And God say, wait a minute. Why are you trying to satisfy and feed your flesh? I never told you to do that. I told you to crucify that thing. Amen. Yeah. The other day was one because I'm using my tablet for the first time. And I'm like, and I brought my Bible just in case that one goes out. I'm like, I'm just talking about it. Amen. But these two scriptures point out very clearly the peril of an empty soul and how vain it is to put trust in the things, the world and the carnal pleasures. As Christians who have been born again by God's Spirit, it is foolish to trust in empty things of this life. In order to be truly satisfied in this life, we must invest our life in those things that have eternal value. Now, what has eternal value? The kingdom things. Amen. The kingdom things. And I want to give you some points here this morning. I hope you learned something this morning. You know what? I was going over this last night and then again this morning. You know what? And it taught me some things. Amen. It is God's desire for each of us to experience God meeting our deepest needs with the spiritual fullness that flows from His being. His desire is to bring us into a place of spiritual fullness. It is not, maybe I'm wrong, but it is not God's desire to give you all the luxurious things. The nice car, the big house, the big bank account. That's not His desire. Now, that'll be a byproduct, but that's not what He desires. What He desires is, you know what? That you, your spirit, man, will be full of His glory and His presence and His goodness. And everything else, I'm telling you, everything else, you know, I learned it the hard way, but everything else is a byproduct of you serving God. Amen. And He always told me in Scripture, you know what? Seek ye first the kingdom of heaven and His righteousness, and everything's going to be added. So if I worry about my carnal and not my spirit, then guess what? But if I worry about my spirit, man, get things out with God and do what He says and hear His voice, everything else is going to follow. We can see back and we can see all the financial things take place because now we're on the right road. Amen. Amen. But we have to understand that material things will not satisfy you. Right? Because how many of us get happy when we get a big old check? We're hollering, praise God. But then when the money's gone, what? That's the flesh. But if we're living by the Spirit and we have Spirit, the fullness of God in us, the Spirit of God in us, the spiritual fullness, whether the money coming in or it's not coming in.
Amen.
Because I understand that I don't live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. Amen? How many are to learn some things this morning?
Amen.
Psalms 36:8, are you there? It says this, they are abundantly satisfied with the fullness of your house, and you give them drink from the rivers of your pleasure. They are abundantly. They, who is they? They are those who trust in the Lord. Amen. They are those who trust in the Lord. They will be satisfied with fullness of your house, and you give them drink from the rivers of your pleasures. We shall be overwhelmed with the plenty of it. We won't even comprehend. It's like, I was back then, I was looking at the commentaries, and then one of them talked about how, where it says that you will be overwhelmed Let me read Amplified here real quick. They relish and feast on the abundance of your house, and you cause them to drink of the stream of your pleasures. And here it talks about how it's like a man being drunk. We're so consumed in the abundance of who God is that we can't comprehend it. Because it's so good. That is what he's talking about, being spiritually full. That we're so full of God's presence, of His goodness that He gives to us. You know what? That I'm not even aware of the stuff going on around me, all the bad stuff, because I'm so drunk, if you put it that way,
Come on.
With His fullness.
Man, yes.
How many of you used to get drunk? I don't know, maybe it's part of me. Right? You get drunk, and you know what? You want to worry about all you're worried about is you. How good you felt, how you were taken over by that alcohol or whatever, right?
Yes.
What about if we got so drunk in the spirit,
yes,
the things of God,
yes,
that you know what? We won't bother about all this little stuff, because you know what? We were now being guided by what we knew was God. Here it says that He's going to give us a drink. Now, let me tell you something. When we say, "Well, God's going to give us a drink," it's not going to be like this.
Come on now. Right.
I want you to picture God pouring Himself over you. That is not God.
Come on.
And here it says, you know what? And it talks about the river, right? I'm trying to take off here. They shall be abundantly satisfied with the fatness of thy house. The word fatness means the richness. Amen? Of thy house and the river of thy pleasures, or the rivers of thy plenty supply. But the word river here, it means not a running fountain or a gentle bubbling, but or not even a stream that will dry up, but a river, a large, full, overflowing, inexhaustible.
Amen.
Are we getting this morning? That's what he's talking about. That we come and he gives us of his inexhaustible, a flowing river.
Yeah.
It doesn't stop every now and then. It doesn't dry up. It's continually going forward,
going.
That's what he wants for you and for me. But you know what? It's those that seek him, those that trust him only. He doesn't give that river to just anybody. So if you want, that's what he did this morning. Change. Change comes when you bow down before the king and say, "No, Lord, I need you." It's nothing that you have to do other than obey. Because you know what? In order for you, for God to open the rivers to flow in you and in your household, guess what? You have to do what he's saying.
Amen.
Because a lot of us, we still need a lot of work.
Yeah.
A lot of construction.
So good. Thank you, Jesus.
Because we want to hold that river of God, that of God that is flowing. But you know what? We got a lot of leaks in it.
Come on. Yeah. Yeah.
We can't hold it. Because we're not constructed the way He wants us to. You know what I'm saying?
Good.
But we have to understand that the river, as He pours His river in us, does the river go and stop at a point? It's forever flowing, right?
Oh, that's good. Yeah.
When He pours Himself in us, we should be forever.
Yes. Good.
Spiritual fullness that I'm talking about this morning. How many want it this morning?
Amen.
Honestly, right?
Amen.
You know what? That we have to be the ones that seek it out. Amen? I thought I'm trying to do my little tablet. They can see how I thought I'll mess it up here this morning.
Oh, Jesus.
They are abundantly satisfied. Those who seek Him, those who trust in Him, are abundantly satisfied with fullness of your house, and you give them drink from the rivers of your pleasure. What is meant by spiritual fullness? Joy. God in His presence. Wisdom and understanding. Divine guidance and healing. Amen? Finances. Emotional needs. Peace. Righteousness. Freedom from guilt. Knowledge of God's will. Spiritual rest. All these things we have need of. But how do we get there is a question, right? I believe God wants us to open our mouth wide and be filled.
Yeah.
Go to Psalms 81:10. I'm not going to be long here. Can I take my shoes off for a minute?
Yeah.
I was going to watch it. It's all right. I'm comfortable here. It says, "I am the Lord your God who brought you out of the land of of Egypt.
Yeah.
Now, what is the land? What does Egypt represent? Bondage.
Yes.
I am the Lord your God who brought you out of the land of Egypt. Open your mouth wide, and I will fill it. What does it mean to open your mouth wide? That means that you speak and you pray and you praise God.
Yes.
And what does it mean by I will fill it? That means whatever you say, you will have.
Yeah,
man.
Good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He says, open your mouth wide and I will fill it. How many are ready to open our mouth wide?
Amen.
The right things now.
Yes.
I am the Lord your God who brought you out of Egypt and the land of Egypt. And open your mouth wide, I will fill it with prayer and praise. With prayer and praise. I will fill it with prayer and praise. Amen.
Yeah.
We have to open our mouth. You know what? Sometimes we don't know what to say. Just open your mouth and God will speak through you and declare some things right by the Spirit inside of you. Amen. But we have to get to that place. There's seven keys to receiving God's fullness. Are you ready for them? There must be a thirsting and a seeking for God. You must thirst and you must seek after the things of God. Amen? Psalm 63:1 says, Oh God, you are my God. Early when I seek you, early in the morning when I seek you, my soul thirsts for you, my flesh longs for you. The word thirst, it means to a suffer thirst. Anybody ever been like, oh Lord, I need you. I'm about to die because I'm thirsty. Lord, I need more of you, God. Anybody ever been there? We have to seek Him that way and understand that if we don't have of Him, we will die. Spiritually. Right? But we have to understand, how do we seek Him? How do we seek Him in word and in prayer? We have to understand, if we don't have this word, if we don't seek Him in His word or in prayer time, guess what? We will spiritually die. But yet, we as a church, we neglect prayer time. We neglect word time. We neglect the spending time with God. And then we want to wonder, and I'm speaking for myself too, and then we wonder, Lord, why am I hearing your voice? Why do I feel like giving up? Why do I feel this? Why do I feel that? Now we're satisfying the flesh, because the Spirit has been satisfied by seeking the things of God.
Amen.
He says, Oh my God, you are my God. You are my God. Not this over here, not that over there. You are my God, and because you're my God, I'm going to seek, I'm going to get up early in the morning. If you look at every study, that's what it says. I'm going to get up early in the morning. When everybody's going to sleep, I'm going to get up.
Amen.
And I'm going to seek you like never before. I'm going to read like never before. I'm going to study like never before. In other words, what I'm going to do early in the morning, I'm going to feed my spirit, man.
Amen.
Amen. My soul thirsts for you. My flesh longs for you. For you in a dry and thirsty land where there is no water. The word dry there, it means a drought, a desert, a barren land, a wilderness. Anybody ever been there? So we have to seek Him. Like, you know what? Like we're walking, in, our spiritual walk is like in a desert. There's nothing there. There's nothing happening. If you're out in a desert with no water, what's going to happen? Why? Because your body has to have water. I'm going to tell you this morning that your spirit man has to have contact with God.
Yeah.
Simple as that. Your spirit man has to have contact with God. Amen?
Come on. Yeah.
We will not neglect our flesh.
Uh-huh.
We're going to feed it every day.
Uh-huh. You know it.
If we don't have money, we'll find something to feed it.
Yeah.
But our spirit man is dying. And then we go days and days and weeks and months without feeding it the Word of God.
Uh-huh. Right. Come on,
I've been there. I'm telling you, that's why I'm saying that. I've been there. I've done that.
Come on.
Lord, I don't talk to you about it anymore, Lord. What have you put in? Well, I said, I've been busy. I ain't got no word in here, Lord. What is that? I want to speak. He's been feeding it.
Right.
But I think I'll gain some balance in the natural, right? There must be a thirsting and a seeking for God. Matthew 5:6 says this, Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be filled. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness. Hunger means to crave, to be needy, to seek with eager desire. Those who do that will be filled in abundance and will be satisfied. Amen. I don't know about you, but this sounds like a promise to me.
Amen.
We come to God and we feel spiritually drained. Like nothing's happening. We feel, you know what? I'm spiritually dead. But then God doesn't answer. Those who hunger and thirst after righteousness, who crave after my things, they will. They will. It's a promise, is that not right? That I will, if you seek after me, if you seek after me of my things, I'm going to fill you. I'm going to satisfy you.
Yes.
Not how you think in the natural, but in your spirit, man. I'm going to satisfy you. And then, in other words, I'm going to quench you.
Yeah.
I'm going to quench that thirst. Anybody thirsty, get a drink of water? When was the last time we quenched our spirit, man? When it was dying of thirst or dying of absence of God's word or His presence in us. Amen?
Yes.
So guess what, church? There's no substitute for filling your spirit, man. Can I go here? We can't sit and listen to the radio all day long, and then you're going to fill your spirit man with that.
Come on.
Or watch TVN, Daystar, or whatever they got out there, and think, I'm good with that. No, you have to seek for yourself.
Yeah.
Because you know what? What happens is you awaken something in you.
Amen. Come on.
I just watch Daystar all day long. Praise God for Daystar, but you know what? That is not a relationship with God. That's a relationship with Daystar.
Watch out. Woo! Uh-oh.
Another one says, spread, Psalms 143:6 says, spread out my hands to you, my soul longs for you like a thirsty land. So we're getting the picture, we have to seek and thirst the things of God. Amen. Psalms 107:9 says, for He satisfies the longing soul and fills the hungry soul with goodness. These are all promises.
Hallelujah.
Now, I can't seek for you and I can't thirst for you.
Exactly. Come on.
Yeah.
Right.
You have to do that. Well, Pastor, it's just that I'm not hungry for the things of God. But you know what? You went hungry for a water burger because you've seen the commercial of a water burger, right? You know what? Put some TV on if you have to.
Yes.
That'll stir it up. But one thing, what I did last night, I said, you know what? I'm going to put some YouTube on, some radio, some minutes, right? Some word going for, some prophecy going for. What happened? You can't stir me, stuff. You know what? Let me go read some stuff here. See, it aroused the hunger in me for more of what he was talking about.
Yeah.
Amen? That's what we need to do. Now, don't stay there with this. You know what? I don't go to church. I'll stay here and watch this right here. I already watched Pastor Field. I go watch Pastor whoever's going. No. But you know what? Use that as a key to get you started.
Amen.
Amen. Now, we can't listen to music just to wake up your flesh. But your spirit. That's why we listen to a lot of prophetic music. Because that about this, for me, it might be goofy, but for me, it's such a thing. You know what I'm talking about? It awakens it in me. I think I put it on Facebook last night about your destiny. I went now. Something about your destiny. Awaken your destiny by hearing the word of God or the voice of God. Because your destiny and the voice of God, the word of God, are one and the same. Amen. How do we get there? How is destiny put inside of us? By the spoken word of God when it's declared over you. Amen. So we have to understand. We have to seek and we have to thirst. Even if you don't feel like it.
Yes.
Even if you don't feel like serving, seeking God, or looking at His Word, pick it up anyway, because I promise you, the moment you pick it up, and you begin to read, and God God begins to give you a more hunger for His Word than ever before. And then you'll see change coming. You'll see transformation taking place. Why? Because now your spirit man is leading you and not your flesh. Because God is looking for a people that are not moved by what they feel or by what He said. Amen. And how does it do that? By seeking and thirsting after God and God alone, not after anything else.
Amen.
But see, what happens is us in the church, we get an appetite for something else. We get an appetite
God's word in us and not give place to what the flesh cutter. Because you know what?
the French can tell us, oh, we can beat ourselves up. We don't need help of the enemy.
Yeah. Come on now. Yes.
Right?
It's true. Yeah. Yeah.
But the spirit man will say, you know what? It'll connect with the heart of God and it'll begin to breathe life into you.
Amen.
Whereas your flesh is speaking death. Amen? So we have to speak. We have to have a life of, you know, spending lots of time praying in the spirit. How much time? However you need to.
Yeah.
But I don't know what I'm saying, but your spirit man knows what he's saying. God understands what you're saying.
Yeah.
Because if, while you're praying in the spirit, God will begin to reveal some things to you.
Yes.
Brings forth revelation. It'll encourage you, amen? Number three is, have a real love for time you spend with God in His Word. Have a real love for the time you spend with God in His Word. And I mean, what I mean is, you know what? Don't just read it and just go. No, I mean, look at it as, you know what? As God's letter to you, as He's speaking life into you, that I need this. Don't do it as I have to, but do it as I must. I'm praying this thing. I pray the Word of God. Amen? Because the Psalms 119, 165 says this, great peace have those who love your law, and nothing causes them to stumble. Psalms 119 and 165 say that. Great peace have those who love your law. Now the word love there, and you know what? Those who are intimate with the Word of God. Great is the peace. They will not stumble. They will not go back and forth because they have an understanding of what the Word of God is and what He's saying and what He means to them. But it's a promise that you will not stumble. If your my word is in your heart, you will not fall.
Amen.
Does that mean you don't have anything coming at you? That's not what it's saying at all. But what it's saying is this, that you will not stumble. You will not be moved. Why? You will not be shaken. Because you understand you're intimate with the Word of God. You stand on what the Word of God says. Amen? We have to do that. We have to spend, we have to love, we have to enjoy. See, a lot of us, we see that as a chore. Here I go. I'll go read my word for about an hour. And then we set our clock. Beep, beep, beep. Close it, let's go.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
I'm telling you, I've done that, church. Even in prayer time, I'm sitting there thinking, I'm going to pray for an hour. I'm sitting there about 10 minutes, and I'm like, I'm ready to get up. Why? It's our flesh.
Yeah.
But you know what? Maybe it hasn't happened to you, but it's happened to me. Where God has told me, you know what? I want you to go read. I want you to spend time for an hour. And I sit there and I'm reading and praying or whatever. And as 30 minutes went by, I think that's enough. I'll get up. And I walk out. But my spirit man knows, wait a minute. I need more. Because I've literally done this where I've left my prayer time or reading time, right? And I've got up because, you know what? I got too much to do because I'm sitting there and I'm reading. But in the back of my mind, I'm thinking about all I got to do today. I don't know if it's just me. Or I'm praying. And all I got to think about, okay, today is I'm going to do that, I'm going to do that, I'm going to do that, I'm going to do that. Right? And then that thing interferes with what God is trying to do. And then I go, and I'm not satisfied because my spirit man, because God, my spirit man was picking it up that God was trying to reveal to me. But because I left too early, I didn't get a direction or I didn't get a word from God for me. Because I was satisfying the flesh and not my spirit man. Anybody ever read that before? So we have to spend time, and we have to enjoy. And I look at it as, oh man, here I go again. Psalms 1, verses 1 to 3 says, blessed is the man who delights in the law of the Lord, and his law is, he meditates day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that brings forth fruit in its season, whose leaf also shall not wither, and whatever he does shall prosper. That is a man and a woman of God who spends time in the Word, that whether it's season or either, I'm going to bring forth fruit. Why? Because the Word of God in me is what pushes out the very thing God put in me. Cold water. Oh, man.
ever done a hot baby before jumping in a pool in cold water?
Ooh,
not yet, but I'm going to pretty soon. That's what it's like being in the Word of God.
Amen.
Spending time in the Word of God. Now, in the natural, we neglect it, and we're like, oh, I don't think it's important. But here he's telling us that we want to be like a tree planted in the middle of the river. That we're not going to stumble.
All these things.
Remember what I talked about change, right? But change, what it could be with him, obey. What he says here. We want change, but we don't want to spend time in His Word. We don't want to seek Him. We want to thirst after Him. But we want change. We want to be planted by the roots of living water. We don't want change. We don't want to do what He says to do. Amen. We have to be spiritually minded. Romans 8 says, "For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace."
Yeah.
It could be that we don't have any peace in our life because we're carnally minded.
Uh-oh.
We think like the world thinks.
Uh-oh. Watch out. Woo!
Amen?
It's good.
Isaiah 26:3, it says this, "You will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on you because he trusts in you." Now, that's a good one there, church. You get what it's saying here? He says, Isaiah 26:3 says, "You will keep him in perfect peace." Put your name there. Marcy, he's going to keep you in perfect peace because your mind is stayed on him because you trust in him. No, see here, we can't read between the lines. There's nothing to read between the lines. Except when things are going wrong. Except when things are going in your favor. Except when there's not this, except when there's not that. No. He says, you know what? Then in whatever we do, if we will stay in Him and trust Him, He will keep us in perfect peace. Now remember, peace is not the absence of trouble, but it's the ability to get through it, understanding who He is.
Come on, that's good.
Amen? See, we think peace is, you know what? Okay, He's going to make everything all right. No, He's going to make you understand, you know what? That you're going through this, but I'm with you.
Yeah.
Amen.
Right. Yes.
Right.
Amen? Number five, I'll go through real quick. It's about being a giver and a tither in offerings. We all know Malachi 3:10, right? A lot of times to the storehouse. Luke 6:38 says, "Give and it should be given to you." We know all these things here. You know what? We want change in all these areas. Some of us might want to skip this one. Can we do that, girl? Because God is wanting to bless us over everything in our life. Everything. And I don't know about you, but I want change in everything over my life. I want God to come in and touch every aspect of my life, of my family, of my marriage, of my finances, of my job, everything. And I want Him to change. But then I want to go and obey and do what He asked me to do over these things.
Come on. Woo!
I'm going to use my wife as an example. Me and my wife here. I want my marriage to walk, to work out. Right?
Yeah.
No, that's what I mean. That's how I'm here. But listen, right? Okay, that's okay. You know what? You want you to change your marriage? Okay, you know what? Then you do what I say. And what he's saying is, you know what? You be quiet. You tell me that. You be quiet. But you don't understand. Because those who trust in the Lord, His
right.
Perfect peace is upon
you. Yes.
But you don't understand.
All right.
That's with everything. Lord, you don't understand. I don't have enough money to give. I don't have enough money for this. I don't have enough money for that. Well, have you given what belongs to me? Well, I just told you I don't have. It's not about that. It's about obedience. we want that. Here it is. This, I think it's Luke. I just read a while ago. Give, and it will be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, will be put into your bosom with the same measure that... Well, there it goes. We want the press down, shaken together, running over.
Woo!
Now, God is the God of miracles. But we expect Him to take a penny and press down, shaken together, running over.
Wow.
That's not obedience. Because God, listen to me, church, He requires 10%. Don't get mad at me. I'm just it's on my notes here. I tell you, I had that same mindset.
Yeah.
But my check was $395. $395. Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out, so that times of refreshing may come from the presence of the Lord. For times of refreshing. See, God is looking to refresh and to renew something, but we don't let go of the stuff in the past. We don't forgive. We hold on to these things. And you know what? How can I bring things new when you still hold on to the old? So that times of refreshing may come. I don't know about you, but I'm ready for refreshing.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
But you know what? You can't stay and hold on to that junk. Right? When we talk about spiritual fullness, all the aspects of our life, our money, our minds, our emotions, everything. God wants to fill everything. But you know what? He requires for us to do something.
Yes.
Amen. I'm almost done. Man, 12 o'clock already? Oh, Lord, sit down. That was number six. Number seven is this. Learn how to rest in God. Isaiah 30:15 says this. For thus saith the Lord, the Holy One of Israel, and that return and rest you shall be saved, and quietness and confidence shall be your strength, but you would not. Psalms 116:7 says, return to your rest, O my soul, for the Lord has dealt bountifully with thee. Matthew 11:28 says, come to me, all you who are labor and heavy laden, I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your soul. Come to me who are heavy laden. Why don't we come? Take my yoke upon you. Now, what is a yoke? A yoke is to guide you. In other words, we're saying, you know what? Take my ways and let that guide you. Amen? Let that give you rest. In other words, and dependency on what He's already done. Not what you can accomplish or what you can do or what you can change. But see, we're the kind of people, right? That we're hands-on. We're like, okay, I want her to change. Let me change. Yeah. Right? I love you, honey. No, I didn't like that, right? Come to Him. We have to be willing to come to Him. Lay everything down before Him.
broken boy, just real quick. There will be a thirsting and a seeking for God. Amen. We'll spend lots of time praying in the Spirit. We have to have a real love. We have to enjoy the time we spend with God in His Word. Amen. We have to be spiritually minded. We have to be givers of tithes and offerings. We have to have a continued heart of repentance. We'll mess it up. Go before God. Don't try to hide it from Him. Amen. Let Him know, hey, look, Lord, I messed up. You know what? Here I am. And you know, but why is it so important to God? Because He realizes that if you don't release that, the enemy will put it in your face every single time you try to move forward.
Yes.
You'll be doing good, you'll be doing good, doing good, doing good. And all of a sudden, you'll trip with that. Remember this?
Right.
And you can't argue with Him. Why? Because you kept it in your heart, you didn't release it. He's right in a sense.
Yes.
Because we never gave it to God. We have unrepentant sin that has held us bound and not enjoyed the fullness of what God called us to be. Why? Because every time we hold on to this stuff and we carry it, the enemy knows.
Yes.
But we don't let it go. Amen?
Amen.
So do this. You know, we have to have a heart of repentance. Amen. We have to let God know everything. Not that He doesn't know, but you know what? Clear our conscience. Amen. Get rid of from our heart. So that way the enemy has it against us. And we have to learn how to rest in God. Amen. Learn what He did, what He's accomplished. Amen. Because everything that God has called us to be, it's there. We have it.
Amen.
But we don't walk the road sometimes. Well, Pastor, I don't know how to get there.
Right.
See, this really covered up a lot of stuff. If we was to do this here, if we was to seek after God and enjoy the time we spend with Him, you know what? The enemy can never attack our mind, who we are in God, our finances, our family. He has no control over nothing. Why? Because we're ready. We're prepared.
Yes.
Right. Because we're truly giving over to Him, to God. And that actually comes and says this later. I said, wait a minute. I know what God said, but I spent time with Him. Amen? But we have to do this. We want change, but to be obedient. Without change, without obedience, there's no change taking place. Because you know what? If you ever change by now, why is that? Because you're still doing things. You're still in control. Right? So what we're doing is, Esther's doing this, taking this, and giving it to God. Okay, Lord, what do you want me to do now? Yep. Well, not only that, but when He speaks, He says, okay, I want you to do this. Well, what else you got, Lord? Okay, you know what? I want you to go, and I want you to go and tell your wife your stuff. Well, no, what, let me see. What else you got, Lord? What else can I do? Right? I want you to go and tell this person that you forgive them for doing them wrong or talking about it. What is it, God, Lord? I'll tell you, that day I did that, that one weekend here, I was set free.
Amen.
You know why? Because the enemy, he had no more chains on me anymore.
Amen.
He can never say, well, I did. I repented and I took to God. Right? We have to have that same attitude. Amen? When God speaks, don't look for an alternative. It's either God's way or no way. Amen? Because if we're doing it our way, then who's Lord? We look in that mirror. And if you're Lord, then you are the one that's in control of the finances, of your family, of your mindset, of your all of these things. You're in control of that. And I'm sorry, but you can't do nothing about it. Not without God. I think I'm done. Amen?
Amen. Somebody can go here. Bless you. Really quick, don't forget, on July the 25th is our youth rally here at Lighthouse Church. Minister Lorenzo Flores will be here from IM International. If y'all don't know him, believe me, y'all want to. He's the spirit-filled man of God that's going to bring the word. So if you know any youth that would like to come, bring him, even adults. I really believe he's going to be ministering in general to the church. But if you know any adult, any children or adults that really need to be here, invite them, invite them. So that is going to be on June the 25th. We will be going to Schulenburg August the 2nd. We will be ministering in Schulenburg at the Pastor Williams Church. Pray for us. We will, for those that don't get to go, we'll be periscoping a little bit of it, not a lot of it. So just continue to pray. Pray for all these upcoming events as they come forth. Amen. Thank y'all so much for helping with the finances for the intern. We raised $474. So that was really good. So that was all God. We love you guys. Be blessed. Allow God to use y'all this week. And just do what God tells you. Amen. For all our Periscope viewers, we'll be back on again live Wednesday at 7 p.m. at our 7 p.m. service. We love you guys. Be blessed.